Me, Mr. Learnmore, Seymour, get at home. I almost missed something in Kyoto. The very road, the very time I went down one road, which I showed you, but I found quite interesting temples, which you find almost no descriptions of or no info about. I went to Kyoto Station to go back to Tokyo. I also went there to go to a store of a matcha maker to get some things. And I almost did not go into another store because it somehow felt a little bit strange to me because of, well, my own attitude about things. But fortunately, I did go inside. The store was the Kyoto main branch of Malbranche. I'm not sure how you are supposed to say it, what they are supposed to be, if they are named after the French... What was he again? I just found that there is a Mr. Malbranche who was a French monk or something. The store has been around since 1982 anyway, so the company. And they are among the many places around Kyoto which make different kinds of pastries and including some with matcha. And among those was what I found, what I noticed looking inside from out. Their langue de chat, their cat's tongues, which are made with okoicha, so with the thick matcha. It's two crisp cookies and a layer of white chocolate inside. I'm just looking. This looks like there's also some matcha in the middle, although actually I thought there wasn't. Well, maybe I've had it lying around for too long and so it colored it all like that. They basically don't send anything anywhere or do anything like that. You would have to go to Kyoto or to another one of their stores to get that. They use the world famous Uji matcha, of course. There are those cat's tongues. There are other things, other pastries they make. Also some with Kyoto chestnuts, for example. And that was all nice. Those taste well. They really use a strong matcha flavor, which is good. But then the really funny thing for me was that in this very same store, where I almost did not go in, because what's this sort of French name, but somehow not quite? How does it fit? Does it really make sense? Then once I was inside and had a look around, I found that actually they also make chocolates. And one chocolate they made, well, easy enough, is again matcha, or rather okoicha, thick matcha chocolate. They make them all with those two layers of wood and the chocolate inside. So in a very interesting design, which I had never seen anybody make before, which is really nice. And when we actually look at the chocolate, you will notice that it is a very dark one, very nice one. Well, dark from matcha one. And then, looking around, I also found the only time in Japan where somebody did something that sounds really quite crazy, spice-influenced. So, just perfect for me. They also make a chocolate bar, which is black sugar and black shichimi. So, shichimi togarashi. The seven flavor, seven spice mixture that Japanese like to use on ramen and udon, but here in a version, in the black version, which is already rare, and also with black sugar, so like our brown sugar more or less. So this is going to be very interesting in flavors. It's a very different kind of combination, which I had never seen anywhere before, and which I'm obviously, from what I'm interested in, looking very much forward to trying out. And so, how is it with those chocolates from Malbranche? They are made in a very nice design. Yes, I have eaten some of them already. So they're making the Cure of Kyoto in their design. The Shichimi one is kinda like a normal looking dark chocolate. The matcha one, well, obviously very green. A bit of a violet sheen on the Shichimi. Also a bit of a lacquered sheen on the matcha one. The Shichimi version is actually in texture a bit grainy, probably a bit like how they describe it, like the traditional sugar candy, cane sugar dry sweets that are traditional Japanese. The matcha one is also a bit grainy, but much less. Well, of course, since Shichimi has different seeds in it. The Shichimi version, I wish it were a bit spicier, a bit more central, maybe. It is very, well, not very strong in taste, let's put it like that. Just chocolate, sweet, interesting, some interesting notes, but not too strong. The matcha version is a really Goicha version, a really strong matcha. This is quite fantastic. I really like that one.